A requested molecule from you for us to break down is known as niclosamide, which is an FDA-approved treatment for a tapeworm infection. And it has a molecular structure that looks like this, which is highly specific to those tapeworms due to its low absorption in our gut from poor water solubility. And when it's absorbed by those tapeworms, it's going to exert its effects on the mitochondria. And before we talk about how it affects a tapeworm's mitochondria, first let's look at normal mitochondrial function. Within the mitochondria, there's a mitochondrial matrix that houses a lot of hydrogen atoms, as well as an intermembrane space. And those hydrogen atoms are going to move from the mitochondrial matrix to the intermembrane space via the electron transport chain. That triggers ATP synthase, or ATP to be produced, which is energy. However, when niclosamide is added, it's going to insert itself directly into the intermembrane space. From there, hydrogen atoms try to move into the intermembrane space, but niclosamide is going to shuttle them right back to the mitochondrial matrix. Therefore, they don't pass through the electron transport chain. So we see decreased ATP being produced. Additionally, this can cause the cell to try to overcompensate and try to start consuming a lot more oxygen, which can lead to reactive oxygen species being produced that causes damage to other organelles in the cell. This further leads to more cell death and eventually the death of that tapeworm. So make sure to leave a comment below for the next molecule you want to see broken down, and stay connected to my channel and with Dane Garvin.